Welcome everyone to our time of worship. Psalms 95:6 says, O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. Let's prepare our hearts for worship as we listen to the song of reflection, Ye Heard. The call to worship comes from Psalms 145, 8-9, 17-18, and 21. The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and faithful in all he does. My mouth will speak and praise the Lord. Let every creature praise his holy name forever and ever. Let us all worship God.
Lord, prepare to be a sanctuary, pure and holy. Tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary. I'll be a living.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for allowing us to come together through video to listen to your message given to us by Pastor Anne. I pray that you bless our hearts and our minds, that we shall take in the lessons that you provide for us and use them in our everyday lives. And as we sing our songs of praise, we just want to proclaim that you are our Almighty God. You are omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent, Lord. You are our Savior, Jesus Christ, and we just ask that as we continue to praise your name online, and that you provide us with your strength and wisdom. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let us sing our songs of praise. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day. Let's rise and declare his glory from the songs. Mighty is our God in the potter's.
Glory to our God. Good afternoon po, Pasadena Yemelief Church. Kamusta po kayong lahat dyan? It's a wonderful pleasure to be delivering the word for you today. And I pray na ma-bless kayong lahat through the blessing of the Holy Spirit. And our theme for this day is the most valuable man in town. And the text is found in Acts chapter 4, verses 12 to 14. And I'm going to read the following passages. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Now, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated, common men, they were astonished, and they recognized that they had been with Jesus. But seeing the man who was healed standing beside them, they had nothing to say in opposition. Before we start, let's bow our heads in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon. Lead us, Panginoon, through the power of your Holy Spirit. Speak to our hearts and into our minds as we dig deeper into your word. This we ask in the most precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, these following passages in Acts 4 is one of the events that happened in the Sanhedrin. And what is found in these verses are the priest and their evaluation of Peter and John. These men were called ignorant and unlearned by the Sadducees. Who are these Sadducees? These are the group of priests that are very learned in terms of the law. And before anything goes to the bigger group, which are the Pharisees, the Sadducees were the first group, and they handled the smaller group in the Sanhedrin. And this is found outside the temple. The Sadducees were not simple-minded to accept apostolic miracles from these men. So, when you are an intellectual and a very learned person in history, in arts, and the letters, and probably sciences, they will not simply accept the apostolic miracles from these men. What is the miracle that happened? They healed someone who was crippled. And of course, they will have to check if this is the work of the Lord or the work of God. But these men were saying that the miracle has happened because of the power of Jesus Christ. So when you say Jesus Christ, the Sadducees are very much alarmed. Ayaw nila na anything miracle in the name of Jesus Christ. Why? Because Jesus Christ was crucified, and there are rumors that he has risen from the dead. And that's another miracle that they do not want to be out in the open. So they had taken up strong prejudices against our Lord, which developed into active enmity and secured our Lord's death. This part of the group of Sadducees were part of those who said yes to Pontius Pilate to crucify Jesus Christ. So definitely, they will be against these men who said that they have healed this person through the power of Jesus Christ. But their gratification passed into intense anxiety when the guard reported and the disciples of the crucified openly declared that he was risen. So they are alarmed and they are anxious, no? ito mga Sadducees na ito. Why? They are learned in the law, in the Pentateuch or the Torah, which is the book of Moses. And lahat ng mga laws na ito ay very much they try to memorize each and every one of them. So, matalino sila, intellectual sila. But apostles would do more to change the world than all in Jerusalem. These people, this group, small group of people, will change the world and even than all in Jerusalem. These 13 men include one doctor, which is Luke, one intellectual, which is Paul, and the rest unlettered, meaning the rest are not very intellectual. Hindi sila matalino. But if you will look at a map of the world and see the impact of their lives, you will see their impact. Even wala, kahit na hindi sila matalino, kahit wala silang pinag-aralan, at kahit bababa lang yung klase ng trabaho nila, yung impact nila sa mundo ay malaki. So, why they were the most valuable men in town then? First, they were not unlearned and ignorant about the Savior. Kailang-kailan nila yung tagapagligtas. Wala silang, kumbaga, marunong sila in terms of alam nila kung ano si Jesus, kung sino si Jesus sa kanila. Sabi nga sa verse 10 ng Acts 4, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" The fact of the healing was recognized. So, the Sadducees were asking, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" So, they know that the healing had happened, no? And the logical conclusion that it was a sign of the presence and working of some supernatural power was not shirked. So, nakita nila firsthand, there's an evidence that that man was healed. And they know that man. And so, they were asking these men and they're inquiring, but the inquiry remained, what is your power and authority? Ano ang iyong kapangyarihan? Ano ang iyong otoridad para magpagaling? So, the Sadducees, these are intellectual people. Alam na alam nila na they can drive out bad spirit, demon possession, by the name and power of the Lord, God Yahweh. But when you are driving and healing people by the name of Jesus Christ, that's unacceptable for the Sadducees. Why? For they thought that Jesus Christ is not authorized to heal, they're not authorized to do anything good. So this man had been with Jesus. The world needs people who have been with Jesus. Kayo ba ay kilala na ba si Jesus Christ personally in your lives? Of course, we have not been with Jesus physically, but through the pages of the scriptures, we can learn his character. No? Many know about science, but few know the Savior. Magaling sila sa anything about natural sciences, the universe, the makeup of how these things work, but they do not know the Savior. Many know about mathematics, no? Matalino sila sa any form of math, physics, geometry, algebra, name it. But few know about the master. Many know about space, but few know about grace. Many know about politics, lalo na ngayon, magulo ang mundo because of politics, but few know about God's plan. Many know about psychology, but few know the one who solves all problems. Alam niyo sa psychology, that's my undergrad, no? People are asking psychologists for help. Mga secular approach ang ginagamit nila, psychotherapy, lahat ng klase ng therapy, but they do not want to put biblical counseling in their mode of healing. So what made this a big mystery to the priest are the educational background of these fishermen that all suddenly they were public speakers and theologians. No? Mga fishermen ito. Mga tax collector, carpenter. Malamang alam nila yung mga manual labor. Mostly sila yung binabayaran to do something menial. And then all of a sudden, they were public speakers. Magaling sila siguro sa rhetoric, no? And most rhetoricians are philosophers and theologians. Now, this is just one proof of what God will do with one who is completely surrendered to Him. Pangalawa, they were not unlearned and ignorant about the scriptures. These men were valuable because of the knowledge explosion they have with the scriptures. Sadly, our increased knowledge has but deepened our dilemma. These men did not know books, but they knew the book. Lincoln once said, "Better to have a knowledge of the Bible than other books." Their knowledge of the Bible equipped them to serve. Now remember, wala pang New Testament in this time. Ang alam nilang Biblia ay yung Old Testament, ano? Isang Hindu ang tinry na evangelize ng isang Christian. And so, what the Christian missionary did was give him the New Testament. And so the Hindu asked, "This is the New Testament, yeah? Is this the complete Bible?" Sabi niya, "No," sabi niya, "but we also have the Old Testament. Now why you don't give the whole Testament, no?" Sabi ni John Golding Gay, you don't say Old Testament. Itong old na ito. There is something that we can learn from the Old Testament. And important na pag-aralan natin to. But in that time and era, yun ang kanilang Bible. And yun ang basis ng kanilang mga batas, laws. And there is something important in the Hebrew Bible that kailangan nilang basahin. Nakalagay dyan yung coming Messiah at maraming nag-aabang nga rito. No? So remember that in studying the Word of God, let's study the whole counsel, not only the New Testament, but the Old Testament. Most great universities in America founded to teach the Bible. This is one of our dilemma. Man foolishly gets too wise for God's book. An imagery of God is written in Psalms 2. "He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh." These men had knowledge of the Old Testament, and their knowledge of the Bible let them know what was happening. Sabi sa Psalms chapter 2, no? That God will laugh Why? Because ang akala ng mga taong ito, matalino na sila. Akala ng mga taong ito, itong mga Sadducees na ito, alam na nila ang lahat. There are some things that they didn't know. And of course, God will laugh in the heavens. So, yung mga ating mga kapatid na Pentecostal, they have this holy laugh, no? They are filled with the Holy Spirit. Sometimes they have this holy anger. Holy anger. Siyempre, Diyos lang ang may holy anger. Or, minsan pagka na-filled sila ng Holy Spirit, umiiyak pa sila, no? And they speak tongues. And, of course, that's part of their giftings. Pero sa ating mga Yemelif evangelical tradition, we don't do that anymore. Or we're not, of course, mayroong mga skeptics in terms of speaking in tongues, but we do not have to pass judgment on them, because there are also intellectual theologians belonging to that group, and sabi nga nila that you cannot be both Pentecostal and intellectual. Pero meron naman. So I want to share a story about these prisoners of war in Japanese camps during World War II, and they endured horrific conditions. A few Christians formed Bible study groups, which brought about amazing transformations within the camps. POWs who had stolen and cheated from one another became men who cared for and gave their lives for their friends. Itong mga prisoners of war na ito, before sila mag-Bible study, talagang survival of the fittest, no? Pero, ang maganda, nag-start sila mag-aral ng Word of God, and so they started caring for their friends. Ernest Gordon in Miracle on the River Kwai writes, "During one work detail, a shovel was missing and the Japanese guard shouted, insisting someone had stolen it. Striding up and down before the men, he worked himself up into a paranoid fury. Screaming in broken English, he demanded that the guilty one step forward to take his punishment." So, ganito-ganito itong Japanese officer na to, because there's a missing shovel. And alam nyo, yung sa World War II, yung mga Hapon, they're very brutal. And they're not Christians. Most of them are Taoist, no? Yung Taoism ang kanilang religion. So, when no one moved, the guards' rage reached new heights of violence. Sabi niya, "All die, all die," he shrieked. To show that he meant what he said, he cocked his rifle, put it to his shoulder, and looked down the gun sights, ready to fire at the first man at the end of the line. Another man stepped forward, stood at attention, and said calmly, "I did it." So, itong Japanese officer na to, sabi niya, "Papatayin ko kayong lahat kung walang aamin." And because this man was so, kumbaga siya ay sobrang mahal niya yung kanyang mga kasamaan, tumayo siya, sinabi niya, siya may gawa. So the guard kicked the helpless prisoner and beat him with his fist. He lifted his rifle high over his head and with a final howl, brought it down on the soldier's skull, who sank limply to the ground and did not move. The men of the work detail pick up their comrade's body, shouldered their tools, and marched back to the camp. When the tools were counted again at the guardhouse, no shovel was missing. What a bad judgment by the Japanese officer, no? Ang ginawa niya, yung butt ng kanyang rifle, tinuktok niya sa ulo nung sundalo hanggang siya'y malumpo. Tapos, nung palabas na sila, wala palang nawawalang shovel. What courage this man did. And because it started with the simple Bible study, the scripture, and the word of God. And number three, they were not unlearned and ignorant about salvation. What is so important in the word salvation? To Noah, the ark meant salvation while others perished. Diba? Sa panahon ni Noah, pinagtatawanan sila because gumagawa sila ng arko, eh napakatirik naman ng araw. Sabi nila, Noah, bakit ka gumagawa ng malaking barko? Eh, wala namang ulan, no? So, for Noah, it means his family salvation. To Israel at the Red Sea, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. In Exodus 14:13. Diba? Sabi ni Moses, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Nasa siya ay nandoon sa sila ay naiipit sa dagat at yung mga incoming Egyptian army na siguradong parehas wala silang kawala. Malulunod sila sa dagat or mapatay sila ng mga Egyptian army. Pero sabi ni Moses, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And the rest is history. For some people, salvation means free from problems and perplexity. No? Sa ibang mga tao, gusto nila yung kanilang yung salvation ay walang problema sa buhay, walang kaguluhan, tahimik. No, but this man from Acts could tell people how to get rid of their sins. This man could tell people how to get to heaven. So this unlearned, uneducated, common men in the book of Acts tell people how to get rid of their sins. Diba? Pag sinabihan ka ng isang tao na walang kamuang-muang, mangmang, tapos sabihin ka na ito yung tamang gawin, para sa iyo, sino ka ba? Bakit mo ako sasabihan? Bakit ko naman kukunin yung iyong counsel, no? At una, dapat hindi tayo magmalaki. Because these men, even though they are unlearned, uneducated, they know the Savior, they know the Scriptures, and they know the way to Jesus Christ. They know salvation. So, in conclusion, Mike Silva, I will read about a piece of advice that he gave. He said, if someone offered you a $20 bill, would you take it? Kung meron nag-offer sa iyo ng $20, kukunin mo ba ito? What if that person weighted up the bill and threw it on the ground, would you still want it? What if he stepped on it, kicked it, and even spit on it? Paano kung yung $20 ay inapak-apakan at medyo, ayun, sinipa-sipa, tapos dinuraan pa, magagamit mo pa kaya ito? Could you still go to the store and spend it? Well, the answer is yes. That bill has value because of what it is, not because of how it looks, where it's been, or what it has been used for. A crisp, clean $20 bill is worth the same amount as an ugly, old, abused one. Walang pinagkaiba yung bagong $20 bill at kahit yung luma at pangit sinira-sirang $20 bill, yung value nila ay parehas. You may feel like you've been stepped on, beat up, or kicked around. You may feel dirty, unworthy, or useless. But be encouraged by $20 bill No matter what you've done, been through, you still have value to God. Remember, you can be the most valuable person in your area. The need is great. Give your life to Christ for His service. Lalo na ngayon, pandemic, people doesn't want to do any good thing to their neighbors. Takot ang mga tao. This is a good opportunity to do a good deed. No? Why? Yung mga tao ayaw tumulong eh, pero ikaw tutulong ka. This means take time to be with Jesus. Saturate your mind and heart with the Bible and carry the message of salvation to others. This is also the best time to share the message of salvation to other people. And sometimes, ito lang ang importante, no? Ito lang ang kailangan nila marinig. Yes, you can do good things, magbigay ng pagkain, but don't forget to share Jesus Christ to them. God will use you to change the world, no matter how small. No matter how you think you're useless you are, tandaan natin that just like the $20 bill, no? Even it's old compared to the new one, it has the same value. I remember one person who kept a coin in a pocket, and this coin comes with the picture of Winston Churchill. Now, what makes this special is because if you are in a coin in UK, in United Kingdom, it means your royalty. It means you're a monarch, a king, or a duke. Pero si Winston Churchill ay nasa coin na ito. So every time na he's feeling down and he's feeling so depressed, he just took out that coin. Why? Even a common man like Winston Churchill, if he can be put on a coin, that means he's someone important. And much more tayo, we are important to God's eyes. We are loved by Jesus Christ. So we hope, and I hope, that this would be an encouragement to each and everyone na feeling natin we're so useless and we're so down. We can get this opportunity, grab this opportunity to do something good to others. Let us bow our head in a closing prayer. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon. Bless each and everyone. And may your Holy Spirit be our protection and our guide in our walk with you as Christians in this modern day era. We praise you and we thank you in the most precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling. I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it
sending forth comes from Matthew 14:16-21. Jesus replied, "They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat." "Bring them here to me," he said. He directed the people to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and 2 fish and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. They all ate and were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon. Thank you for giving us wisdom and knowledge to be receptive in your word. We thank you, our dear Father, for your Son, Jesus Christ, who has revealed himself to each and every one of us, which brings us the presence of your Holy Spirit, guiding us in this lifetime. And so we thank you for your protection. We thank you for giving us our needs. And we thank you, O Lord, especially to your Son, Jesus Christ, who has sacrificed his life for the salvation of many. Now, as I lay my hands, I raise my hands this afternoon, may the presence of the Holy Spirit be to each and every one of us. Now, to him who is able to keep you from falling, to present you without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, whose dominion and authority is forever and ever. Amen and amen.
You and keep you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you
and give you peace,
and give you peace,
and give you peace,
and give you peace. The Lord
make
his face to shine upon you
and be
gracious
unto you.
And be gracious. The Lord be gracious, gracious unto you.
Amen.